Hey there, guys. How's it going? So I want to talk a little bit about the boxing that took place last night on ITV. Now there was quite a lot of fights last night. However, the only card I managed to watch was the Erik Skoglund versus Callum Smith fight that took place. That fight was on ITV4. So shout out to ITV for giving us some free boxing there. I got to watch the whole card. It was a pretty good card. There was quite a few knockouts. Martin Murray was on the undercard. And he actually looked really good. He fought some Armenian guy that's based in Germany. And yeah, Martin Murray did a really good job, broke him down to the body and took him out in 4 rounds. And I believe that guy had only been stopped once in his career. So yeah, Martin Murray's still about. And I believe somebody on the commentary team mentioned that Martin Murray is going to be kept as a reserve for this World Boxing Super Series at 168. So, he's still in the mix. He's still around. So, anyway, yeah, just wanted to talk about the main event. Now, I got to be honest, guys. I was kind of disappointed because as I was watching the fight, Callum Smith was a big favorite going into this fight. Everybody expected him to win this fight. I expected him to win the fight. However, I've got to be honest, Erik Skoglund actually did surprise me. The reason why I was disappointed is because as I was watching the fight, I felt that Erik Skoglund had the ability to win the fight and win the fight easily from what I was seeing. I mean, he had the better boxing skill, the better movement, far better defense. Callum Smith, I mean, Callum Smith, guys, he looked so stiff, so rigid, no head movement whatsoever, no guard. He was a sitting duck for that left jab of Erik Skoglund. Erik Skoglund in the sixth round, I mean, he busted Callum Smith's nose with his jab, and I had Erik Skoglund up at that point. And Callum Smith, to me, after getting his nose broken and after just the way that that round was going, those repeated left jabs that were hitting him, I thought that Erik Skoglund had a perfect opportunity to then get himself a victory. But the problem is, Erik Skoglund did not have the confidence to let his hands go and actually throw some power shots. When he started having success with the jab, and when he broke Callum Smith's nose, and when he was hitting Callum Smith at will with that left hand, it was like Erik Skoglund was content to just sit back and just hope that his jab carries him to victory. But if you're a guy who's fighting overseas in your opponent's hometown, and the fight was in Liverpool, in Callum Smith's hometown, when you've moved down in weight, when you're facing a guy that's a bigger puncher and a guy that's obviously got the crowd behind him, you need to take the initiative. It's all well and good being able to out-jab the guy, but if you're not throwing any power shots, you're not going to discourage him. So while Erik Skoglund had the ability to win the fight, to me, he didn't have the confidence. And that was why on the official punch stats, you could see that Callum Smith was the one who was winning the rounds on power punches, because he had the confidence to actually throw power punches, whereas Skoglund, to me, was just relying on his jab and nothing else. And although I think Skoglund, like I said, he was the better boxer of the two, just didn't have the confidence to really take this victory, man. And I felt what he should have been doing was throwing hooks to the body. I mean, you can hit a guy with three, four jabs in the face, but on the scorecards, with the judges looking at that, they're not considering those jabs as power punches. Callum Smith can land one overhand right, and that's equal to landing four or five jabs, on the scorecards with the punch stats. So yeah, I was kind of disappointed in Erik Skoglund. I felt that he had a lot left in the tank when the fight ended. I mean, in the post-fight interview, if you look at the two guys in the post-fight interview, Callum Smith had a busted nose, a busted eye, looked as if he'd really been in a hard fight, looked as if he couldn't have gone another round, whereas Erik Skoglund, to me, looked like he had a lot of energy left in the tank, looked as if he'd really, he kind of just froze to me on the big occasion. It was his first time fighting in the UK in front of a hostile crowd, his first time fighting at super middleweight too. I mean, the guy's been alternating between cruiserweight and light heavyweight, and I just felt that he froze, man. I mean, he, like I said, he had the ability to win the fight, just didn't have the confidence. Callum Smith scored a knockdown in the fight in the 11th round, and like I said, because Erik Skoglund didn't have the confidence to, work the body and throw some power punches and really capitalize on the opportunities that he created for himself with the jab, that gave that kind of gave Callum Smith an incentive to just come back in the fight and throw punches on the inside, because Callum Smith, obviously, he has confidence in his own punching power. The guy's a very heavy-handed fighter, very big for the weight. And he to me just seemed like he was more up for it, and I just felt that Skoglund, to me, he kind of gave the fight away. He really did. I really felt he gave the fight away. I thought it was very questionable performance, and what was also kind of questionable was in the post fight interview. Erik Skoglund said in the interview, he said something like, "I'm just happy to be here, and I'm just happy to be a part of this," as if he was just happy to be a part of the whole event. Whereas if you listen to Callum Smith's interview, he was like, no, this was a must-win fight for me, you know. I really, really want to win this tournament and get that trophy. You know, he showed a lot of desire. So, yeah, it just goes to show you can have all the boxing skill in the world, all the talent in the world, but if you don't have the confidence and the drive to really dig deep to get a victory, you're not going to be as successful, are you? So, yeah, disappointed in Erik Skoglund, but a good win for Callum Smith anyway. Callum Smith advances to the next stage in the tournament. I believe he's going to be facing the winner of Jürgen Bremer against Rob Brandt. That fight's happening, I think, is it next month? Yeah, I'm pretty sure that fight's happening next month. That's going to be an interesting one. It's happening over in Germany. I'm kind of favouring Rob Brandt in that fight because Rob Brandt's much younger, much fresher at this stage. Bremer's been out of the ring for a year and has suffered a few injuries in recent years. So I'm thinking that Rob Brandt, you know, with having the more youth, the more energy, the more desire, I'm thinking he might pull that win off. So, yeah, we could be seeing Callum Smith versus Rob Brandt. I've got to say, though, after seeing Callum Smith's performance tonight, and how rigid he was and how easy he was hit with the jab, I think that Rob Brandt would be, you know, he could potentially be a favourite to beat Callum Smith. I really do, because I think Rob Brandt is a very, very underrated puncher. He's got a lot of power. You know, Rob Brandt's also a decent boxer too. Yeah, obviously he doesn't have much experience. He hasn't really fought anybody yet, but just based on the eye test, I think that I like what I see from Rob Brandt, and he seems to be you know, very naturally gifted in there. And Callum Smith, I just wasn't impressed, man. I mean, yeah, it's a good victory, but like I said, he was a sitting duck for that jab. I mean, he was just getting peppered with it all night. He made absolutely no adjustments. And if Erik Skoglund, you know, had maybe a little bit more international experience, maybe if he was just a little bit more determined in there, had a little bit more desire, I honestly think he should have won the fight. To me, Skoglund was the more talented fighter. He had the much better footwork, the much better movement, better jab, better head movement, better boxing skill. He couldn't match the punching power of Callum Smith, but, you know, I thought he had enough to win the fight. Just he just didn't go for it to me. You know, I'm sure a lot of you guys will disagree, but that's how I saw the fight. It's going to be interesting because, like I mentioned earlier in the video, Callum Smith, not only was he the favourite for this fight, but I think a lot of people actually had him the favourite for the tournament. But based on that performance, honestly, I think that George Groves and Chris Eubank Jr., two guys who are very fast and very athletic with very good jabs, similar to Skoglund, I don't think they're going to be losing any sleep over Callum Smith on that performance. Obviously, he can improve from it, but it was quite disturbing how, you know, he just didn't make any adjustments with all those jabs he was getting hit with. It was a decent night of boxing, apparently. I didn't watch any of the other fights. I didn't watch the Monroe-Saunders fight, wasn't interested, and I didn't watch the Triple G Canelo fight either. Just wasn't interested in either of those fights, to be honest. Just wasn't interested. Let's just leave it at that. But yeah, the Callum Smith-Erik Skoglund fight, it was an entertaining fight. It was just kind of disappointing. So let me know what you guys think anyway, and thanks for watching.